This is Lisa Mode. I am with Seven Oaks Farm Miniature Therapy Horses, and today we wanted to talk to you a little bit about some of the training we do and how to do certain things. This is Buck. My bigs are coming in. This is Buck. He's 4 years old. He is one of our therapy horses, and he is one that we're going to do a little bit of training with today. The main thing I want to talk about with you today is how you hold your lead rope. The correct way is to have your thumb pointing towards you, and that's something you can kind of remember. Point your thumb toward you, and you know you've got it right. So you want the fat part of your hand towards the horse, and you want your thumb pointing out the other way. The reason we do that is so that it's just like when you're learning to rein with a horse, and your instructor is showing you how to finesse. You would be holding the rein, like say if it was coming back around where it normally would be, you would be holding it like this, and you're finessing it, you know. So you're giving just slow little amounts of movement and getting the horse to turn left or right. Well, that's not what we do when we're training the horses, but if I'm holding his lead like this and say he does something that I don't want him to do as a correction, I can very easily just pop my hand like that. And that gives him a quick reminder, no. And then when he corrected, then I would stroke him and say, you know, good boy. And so those are one of the reasons we ask you to do that. And if you have not worked with horses very long, maybe you have been fortunate enough to not ever experienced the incorrect way of holding a lead, which is like you would hold usually a dog lead. Using that's pretty common. You'll see someone hold their horse like that when they've been used to carrying a dog leash. If you hold your lead rope like this, if he were to pull and I had to get a hold of him, it would run right through my hand. And if you've never had a rope burn, it's bad. It does not feel good. And you'll remember to never do that again if it happens once. And this, you can act as a brake. It's a lot easier to hold your horse if he were to pull away if I just do it this way, from holding it the correct way. If I do it like this, the incorrect way, you're not gonna be able to stop that rope from coming through your hand, all right? And it also makes it harder than to correct, because then you're having to, you know, do this kind of a motion. So that's what we have you always do. So correct way, fat part of your hand towards the horse, your thumb should be pointing towards you like that, and that's a good way to always remember.